Family Feud. Y'all remember that show, Family Feud? And the whole thing, concept behind that show was families who were bonding together were fighting against other families. Is that right?
Amen.
Well, how about when families are not together and they're fighting against one another?
Yeah.
Yeah. And so that's what we want to kind of focus on today. So if Maestro will go ahead and give us our theme music for the day, go ahead, sir. Y'all like that?
I don't want you discipling my kids no more. Because they're my kids.
If your kids
are my kids. Well, them ain't yours.
I tell you what, won't you and your kids get out of my house?
This ain't just your house.
What you mean, ain't my house? I don't have a mortgage up in here.
Oh,
I got
oh, I don't do nothing.
In this house. What you mean? What
you mean? They're my kids.
You don't even cook.
Hello, you're not even their biological daddy. Hello.
Oh, really? Oh, that's how we doing this.
That's how we doing this.
Oh,
since you want to act up,
you and your kids can get out of
here. Yeah, my kids.
Yeah, you and your kids.
Oh, no, sir. You got to go.
You done told me. Get around my house.
You got to go.
Oh, whatever.
Get that though. The deuces, baby. My mama. Oh, then you going to bring my mama in here.
Yeah, I'll tell you.
Oh, then we talking about people mama. Okay, well, what about yours?
Oh, you talking about my mom?
What about yours?
I just told my mom last week, you know my mom.
I do, but I don't like her son.
Whatever.
Have y'all seen them kind of places?
Y'all ain't seen that kind of place.
Well, you get to talking about mamas and daddies
and greasy grannies and holes in their panties. Should I say that? Oh, you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Let me take a swig real quick of this water. Mouth is a little dry. You didn't get any water? That's because I knew we were going to argue. So get your own water. That's my water.
Ooh, that's
my water. It's my water. Hey, I want to focus on what we're talking about this week. This is the end of our love and happiness series. And the thing that we want to focus on this week, we started out talking about single, saved, and struggling. We talked about that. And then we talked about the Deadpool and dating.
Amen.
And then last week we talked about married but miserable. This week we want to talk about family ties. Somebody say family ties.
Family ties.
Say it again, family ties.
Family ties.
And for me, a strong and cohesive family life is the foundation of a successful home.
Amen.
Y'all get that?
No, sir.
A strong and cohesive family life is the foundation of a successful home.
Amen.
And there's no better way for me to us to tie this love and happiness series together other than talking about the family. Is that right?
Amen.
And why would we talk about the family? The reason I say that is because people, a lot of the times, they prepare to be a mate, but they fail to prepare for the possibility of a family.
That's right.
I'm going to say that again. People prepare to be a mate, but they fail to prepare for the possibility of a family. And so some people may say, Pastor Rico, listen, I'm not into the family thing. You know, I'm not ready for that right now. And I don't have time for a family right now. I'm young. I got a lot going on. And why would I be worried about a family? Well, that's fine, you know, and I can understand you feeling like that. But at the same time, I want you to understand that you have to be prepared for what comes ahead. You don't know who in the world you're going to end up with. And anytime you're seeking to be with somebody or seeking a mate, the potential of family ties are there.
Amen.
Regardless of whether you're ready for a family or not, the potential of family ties are always present. And so somebody may ask, what is family ties? Somebody say that. What is family ties?
What is family ties?
To me, family ties are the things that make the family what it is. Family ties are the thing. It's the makeup of your family. A family tie can range from anything, things like how we're going to raise our children, to things like who do we consider as family.
That's right.
That's what a family tie is, because let's be honest, you can have some biological siblings and you don't really consider them as family.
That's right.
Let's be real. But, you know, that's okay, but we want to understand something here. All of these things are important because we never know who we're going to fall in love with and what that person may bring to the relationship.
That's right.
never know who you're going to fall in love with, what they're going to bring to the relationship. You know, sometimes you have to ask yourself, when you're with somebody and all of a sudden they get touchy when a certain subject comes up, and you're wondering, why is this person so touchy about this subject?
That's right.
Why is it that they're so touchy about certain things and so sensitive to certain things? And you're asking yourself this, and I have a question for you. What if you married someone and you didn't know what type of emotional abuse they've been through?
Amen. Amen.
Or what if you marry someone or start dating someone who you don't know what type of practical family upbringing they had or what type of family training they've had, and now you're wondering why, when you get in the middle of it and you start producing a family, you start wondering, why is it that this person behaves this way towards these kids?
That's right.
Even though it could be their biological kids or their stepkids, and we're going to talk
That's
about
right.
step in a minute.
Right.
Why is it? And we never ever consider the fact that what happens, how would I handle a situation if I married someone who had been molested?
That's right.
And so they don't feel like being as intimate at times as I do, or they get a little touchy during intimacy times. Or what if you marry someone where you may have come up in a certain family and had a certain family practice. This person has a different family practice, and they had to grow up too soon. They didn't get a chance to be a kid.
That's right.
You know, maybe mama, daddy abandoned the home, or mama died, daddy died, and that single parent who they were left with raising them needed that person to step up. And so now this person has a certain maturity level, and you don't. And so while you were playing with He-Man and action figures and Barbie dolls, that person was mowing lawns trying to bring some bread home.
Right.
On their grind, getting their grind on, getting their hustle on, trying to do something. And so you may be too playful for that person.
Amen.
You know, you still thinking about Bugs Bunny and stuff like that. You're 30-something years old. That's me, amen. Pretty good. I laugh about stuff. Man, I had a childhood. I'm not going to be ashamed of it either. I enjoyed my Saturday mornings in my underwear looking at cartoons, sitting on the couch, eating a bowl of Fruit Loops. I enjoyed that. And so I laugh about stuff. Stuff comes to my remembrance. As a matter of fact, there's a new commercial, I believe it's a Geico commercial with Elmer Fudd, and Elmer Fudd be saying, "Rascally Wacky." I just be laughing. What is it, Elmer Fudd? Something else. My wife be looking, she don't even pay attention to the commercial. I don't know why. She didn't watch, you didn't watch cartoons.
No, I wasn't a cartoon.
Oh, you missed out big time. Sorry to tell you, you missed out big time. But and so I'm the playful one in the house because I got a chance to enjoy being a kid. And so she's the mature person in the house because I don't know why she's still so mature. Try to act like she's so mature or whatever. Because I'm gonna enjoy my life. What is that?
You old? I'm older than you.
That ain't got nothing to do with it. That don't have a thing to do with it. But anyway, let's move on. And so she has a certain family training, and I have a certain family training. And so what we have to learn to do is we have to learn how to tie things together.
Amen.
Is that right?
We have
to learn how to tie things together. Let me say this. Not everybody defines the family the same way.
That's right.
Not everybody defines family the same way. Not everybody's family look the same. Let's say, for instance, that you come from a traditional family where you had a mother and a father in the house, and you know what it's like to be a spouse. You know what it's like to raise children. You know what it's like to have both in the house. But let's say you marry someone who comes from a sibling family.
Amen.
Anybody know what a sibling family is?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A sibling family is a family that, for whatever reason, maybe mama died and daddy abandoned her.